And welcome to Senior Circuit. We're so glad to have you. Today we have a new colleague who has joined us at the City of Somerville, Betsy Allen, who's our new ADA coordinator. Welcome, Betsy, to Senior Circuit. We're so glad to have you here. Welcome to the city.
Thank you very much.
Brand new, just a month.
I'm thrilled to be here.
Thank you. You've only been here just a month, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. Yesterday was my first month anniversary.
Well, happy anniversary.
Thank you.
I hope there's many, many more to come.
Thank you.
So tell me a little bit about yourself, first of all.
Well, I've been hired to be the ADA coordinator for the city. I'm also going to be directing the Commission for Persons with Disabilities. I have been in the city for about 3 years now. Practicing lawyer. I was doing immigration law up on Broadway. And this opportunity came up. It seems like a perfect fit for me. And so I jumped on it, and here I am.
Well, we're certainly glad to have you, and again, welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit of what is an ADA coordinator, for those who don't know?
The ADA coordinator is responsible for basically everything and anything having to do with disability. We enforce the American with Disabilities Act, which helps persons with disability navigate, basically improve the lives of people suffering from mental, physical, emotional challenges. And so my job is to, first of all, advise the city, along with the commission, research, develop programs, anything you can think of to better the lives of our disabled residents in the city.
So you talked a little bit about a commission, and what is that about?
The commission is where we invite residents of the city to come in, and basically they are our eyes and ears in the community. Most often, they have family members with disabilities, and so they are the point person really to tell us what is working, what is not working as far as our programs, and to also tell us where we're going right, where we're going wrong, what we can fix, and basically provide us with guidance and advice.
Throughout the city, right?
Exactly. The best way.
The best way possible, right. So tell me a little bit about what in your background do you think has brought you to this point to fulfill the need of the ADA coordinator here in Somerville?
That's a very good question. I was working for the federal government, the Social Security Administration. In that capacity, I advised the administrative law judges on whether or not someone should be able to receive SSI benefits, sometimes for a few months or a few years, sometimes for life. And so I would tell the judges, I would read reams of information, sometimes someone's entire medical file, and write a memorandum to the judge saying this person deserves it or this person does not warrant benefits based on the fact that they're not, their illness doesn't amount to a disability. And so I'm well versed in disability laws. Also, I was working with the MCAD for about 8 years. The MCAD, for those who may not know that term, is the Mass Commission Against Discrimination. And there, I investigated, resolved, mediated complaints of discrimination. Also recommended memoranda to the commissioners on whether or not someone was discriminated against.
That's pretty impressive. And I think there's some more, right?
Yes. As I said before, I'm a practicing attorney. And part of my job as an ADA coordinator is to do outreach and training, both our staff and the community. And I used to be a history teacher. And so I'm capable of doing the training and going out and speaking to people.
Well, that is really an amazing history that you have there. Now, in your law practice, did you also do some ADA stuff?
I did. I did personal injury law and also workman's comp and disability issues. And so, really, from the time I got out of college, I've been doing in some form or another the job that that I'm very fortunate to be doing right now. And I'm very happy.
So it's interesting to see whether or not this is something that seems like a lifelong mission. Is there something that brought you to this to be able to serve the disabled person's field so well?
I would say so. I would say so. First of all, I'm not someone who grew up with a lot of money. So even though I myself thank God, knock on wood, I myself am not disabled. But when you grow up with very limited resources, you kind of feel in some way that you're missing out on some things. And so also I have a brother who's got a mental illness and he's disabled. Social Security has determined him to be disabled, which is a really very, very high bar. And with my brother and my life, my background, I just have always had this empathy for other people.
Well, your compassion, your caring shows through. Thank you so much for doing that and telling that story. It's pretty personal, but thank you so much. It is important, and now I can see where your drive is and how it is to go. So I know that you have a vision for, along with the mayor, of where you want to take this ADA position. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, Cindy, I'm sure you know the mayor speaks often and consistently about making the city really an inclusive community for everyone. And for our seniors and our residents with disabilities, this means above all else, providing that equal access that they need. To you and me, we could just walk out the door. But for someone in a wheelchair, a curb cut can literally mean the difference between being trapped at home and going out and having a life. And so the mayor really is committed to achieving this increased access for everyone in the city. He has communicated that to me in crystal clear language. I've seen him communicate that to others. And so when he says that he wants City Hall to be responsive to each and every single resident, he means it. I heard it 3 years ago before I even thought of working for him. I believed him then, I believe him now, and that's why I'm so happy to be on his team doing my part to make that happen for him.
And you're right about how the mayor has really been responsive to that. He does take the opportunity to go out into pretty much all of the senior buildings at one time or another throughout the year and the senior centers. And the one thing that he has heard is how hot it is to get around this curb cut, getting off that street, the light's too short, they can't get across in their wheelchair, they can't get across in their walker. And this has really been a result of the mayor listening to his constituents and really hearing it and making it happen.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And again, if you run the Council on Aging, I see the seniors every single day coming in and they have this joy to be able to have this building, to be able to have fellowship with their fellow seniors. Really, it makes a difference in someone's life when they can have that life-affirming fellowship, that life-guiding information sometimes. I mean, it's the difference between being at home and isolated and having people around you that would talk to you and provide you that kind of support. I mean, we all need it.
We definitely need it, yeah.
Yeah, and when we make our polling places accessible, to us, it's just a building. To them, it's their civic duty. If we don't provide that polling place, then they can't vote. And if they can't vote, someone is ruling over them that they had absolutely no input whatsoever in who that ends up being.
And you're right about being able to have some place to go. And in some instances, we've talked about this already, is that this is the only place they have. They don't really go anyplace else. You know, they can't go to every restaurant. They can't go every place they want to go because of the disability. Mm-hmm. But being able to come here, they would be lonely and isolated if they didn't have a senior center to come to.
Absolutely.
So you're right about that. And we're pleased to have you aboard and part of our team. So tell us what the long plan is. Do you have some specifics that, what are you doing immediately to make things happen?
Well, in the near term, we have two surveys going on right now, almost completed, and we are working on a plan that we already had. But the surveys specifically are concerned with every single street, every single curb in the city. We have the infrastructure survey that will give us the broad view of the city and what needs to happen. And then we have the buildings and programs and policies survey that will tell us what we need to do in terms of providing our residents with facilities and programs that meet their needs. And long term, the mayor wants to make the city a great place for every single resident, whether you have a physical, mental, emotional challenge, or whether you're perfectly fine. That's his vision. That's his goal. He's one of the hardest working people in government. I mean,
He never sleeps. Trust me, he never sleeps.
People tell me he doesn't. He's working very hard. And again, when I heard him speak 3 years ago, I was like, wow, imagine that. I mean, given what's going on in Washington, can you imagine having someone who actually listens to the people?
We're so fortunate.
We really are. And he's working hard, and he's got great people like you.
Thank you.
Helping him out accomplish his vision, and I'm happy to be a small part of it.
Well, thank you. We'll be right back. This is when you get your pen and paper and to write down all those great events that we're having. Welcome back. Can you believe all the activities? We're already talking about the mayor's picnic, and we're talking about fall and Christmas programming. I don't know where this year has gone by. It's May already, and here we are planning December. But we're here today with Betsy Allen, who is our ADA coordinator for the city. And Betsy, how can people reach you?
Oh, they can either call City Hall and ask for Betsy Allen at extension 2323. Or they could dial 617-625-6600, extension 2323.
And the location of your office?
In the Tufts Administration Building, second floor.
And that's
207.
And that's 167 Holland Street.
Correct.
Right where the Council on Aging is, so we have a great partnership there. So we talked a little bit about what some of the vision is, long-term, short-term. We had a ResiStat meeting with the mayor. We had about 100 seniors that day. And one of the concerns were sidewalks, lifting from tree roots, you know, getting by with your walker, getting by with wheelchairs. And is that something that you'll be addressing?
Yes, absolutely. Well, let me just say we have a lot of work to do with respect to our sidewalks. But I don't want people to be left with the impression that we have not been doing anything. We have been doing an amazing amount of work. Every week, DPW is out fixing sidewalks and doing curbs. And so, yes, we're aware that when the trees, as they grow, would tend to lift the sidewalks. And there's at least two departments, including engineering, looking at that, at ways to prevent that in the future and to fix that now, because we do know that seniors in walkers and our disabled residents in wheelchairs cannot really navigate those sidewalks, and that's a problem, and that's a priority for the mayor. It is part of the long-term study, how to effectuate a plan that would, A, prevent that in the future, and B, fix the situation as it exists right now. So we are doing a lot of work. We will be doing some more work. We have a lot to do, and we appreciate people's patience and forbearance, and we are getting to it, and we know the problems are there.
And as the mayor talked about, was if they do have some kind of issue, or if there's something in front of their house, they should call 311 in the city, make that
request.
Make people aware of it, make their request, or I didn't want to say complaint, but make that request that that's there if that sidewalk could be fixed. And I know that everybody that you mentioned, including you as a new ADA coordinator, is working on that program. So,
and also 311 will send those calls directly to me.
Excellent.
So I can call DPW and say, Central Street, this number, problem right now, and have someone come right out and fix it.
Excellent.
And so we all working together. We all on the same page.
And we're all on the same team, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
So tell us a little bit about the state and federal compliances. And I know that we're a city that's pretty well and compliant, but I know there are new rules coming in every day. So talk a little bit about that.
Right. Well, the ADA demands equal access. Again, it's the Americans with Disabilities Act, and it demands equal access for everyone. And our job is to provide that access. Now, we have a plan in place to eliminate barriers now and prevent them in the future. The city is working on its compliance issues. It's an old city. Some of those buildings are old, and some of them are on the historical preservation list. And so there are restrictions to how much you can do to a building that is being historically preserved. But our goal is to make it accessible as best as possible. And in situations where we cannot, we will communicate that to the residents. We will communicate that to the powers that be, the Architectural Access Board. Seek a variance for that particular, because sometimes it is infeasible. You really cannot do it without doing heavy damage to the building and to a certain facility. And so if that is the case, and it's rare that we can't do anything at all, if that's the case, then we'll address it and find ways to move programs elsewhere so people can still have access.
And now you talk about the ADA compliance says that everything, it's a demand that it's compliant for everybody. But there are, as you said, there are old buildings that folks can't get into. And that doesn't mean they don't want to do things. That just means that maybe a business or restaurant or something can't do anything right now.
Correct.
And there are, not every place is compliant at this moment, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they're not trying to be compliant.
Exactly. Not only are they trying to be compliant, in certain instances, just because something is not compliant doesn't mean that the city is necessarily in violation of any rules. We, again, like I was saying, the board, the Architectural Access Board, recognizes that there are certain things that cannot be done. And in those cases, they will work with the local government, in this case, the city of Somerville, or the residents, to arrive at a solution that meets the needs of everyone, be it the business owner or the residents. And in particular cases, if a program is in a building that we can't, for whatever reason, make accessible, the law provides for alternatives. You can move that program elsewhere to an accessible building. As long as people have access to that building, then the compliance piece is in place. And so we're looking at everything.
It seems like you have a lot of work ahead of you, that's for sure. So we're lucky to have you.
Thank you.
And there are many benefits by having you out there looking. And tell us what some of the benefits are for the seniors.
Seniors, well, first of all, they are our eyes and our ears in the community.
They will definitely tell you everything you need to know.
If they see something, I want them to say something.
They will.
I'm sure they will. But the benefits for them, it's really the same for everyone else with a disability. Streets that you can navigate through, sidewalks you can walk on, buildings you can get into, services that you need access to that you get. Seniors have time and they have patience, and they are almost one of our most precious resources in the city. And we want them to have a full and active lifestyle as we do for every single other resident. And so seniors will benefit from our great streets and our curbs when we cut them, and the beautification projects that are going on all over the city, especially with Union Square. I'm sure restaurants are going to be coming in, and seniors have disposable income that some of us raising children
don't necessarily have.
Exactly.
But the nice part is that as they rebuild and grow, everything will be compliant. And that's the nice part about building and renovating is because then they have to make it ADA compliant.
Yeah. Well, first of all, we want to make everything compliant.
Of course.
It's a moral imperative. It's a legal imperative. As I was just speaking to someone yesterday, on April 15th, over two dozen people woke up perfectly abled. You know, they had their legs, they had their arms.
That's right.
And by the end of that day, they were disabled. Disability is something that can happen to all of us. And so morally, it's the right thing to do. Legally, it's an obligation that we gladly take on. Mm-hmm. And we are working to make everything compliant. It's not that we don't want to, but we're a city with, I'm sure the mayor will say, limited resources. And we can't decide tomorrow that we're going to fix everything. That's just not how it works in government or in life. People have to have budgets. And so year after year after year, a certain amount is allocated to fix our problems when it comes to infrastructure and policies and programs. And sooner rather than later, we'll have a city that everyone can enjoy. And not that they're not now.
Exactly. And the mayor has really dedicated so much time and energy into doing this. And I know the seniors appreciate everything they do. And as I said, they grab him at every meeting to talk about it. And he's very quick on answering that call and making sure things happen. Mm-hmm. So we do appreciate that. I do want to show you that our building is 100% compliant.
Yes.
And we're lucky to have that. And here's a nutrition fair that we had just last week. Take a look.
Well, Nutrition Fair, we're so glad to have you here with us today. We've had a great opportunity to have Seth Colburn, who's been with us all year as our intern from Tufts University School of Nutrition, the Friedman School. So we're so thankful to have him to talk about nutrition. Seth, would you like to say a few words?
Well, first up, I just want to thank the Somerville Council on Aging for having me as an intern this year. It's been a great opportunity being the nutritionist for the Fit for Life program. This is the first nutrition fair, and it's been a great success. We've had at least 50, 60, 70 people come, and we have a bunch of local vendors, Whole Foods, Trader Joe's, Dave's Fresh Pasta, some other vendors from the neighborhood come to represent themselves. And we have a cook and a nutritionist from Tufts University coming to speak. It's about to start, so. Once again, thank you very much for having me. It's been a great opportunity to teach people, to teach older adults about healthy eating.
We're here with one of our older adults. This is Martha McLean. Martha, thank you so much. Tell me a little bit about how much you're liking this.
I like it very much. It's very encouraging. I mean, you know, I hope I can follow it.
And what have you tasted? Anything special?
Tasted the yogurt and all that. It's very good.
One of our vendors who comes a lot and visits and helps the seniors is Adele Fisher, and he's from Blue Lotus Body Work and Massage. And Adele, I know you come a lot out and do some work here with the seniors. What's so challenging about working with older adults?
The amount of pressure I use. It's, you know, I have to judge whether a client can, the amount of pressure that they can stand. So that's the biggest challenge. But it's great. I love coming here. I love the people. We have a good time, and anytime the council agent asks me to come, I try to make it.
I'm Kristen Delvicio. I'm the Green Team and Urban Agricultural Coordinator for Groundwork.
Tell us a little bit about what you're doing here with Groundwork.
Oh, well, I'm just trying to encourage people to come out to the schoolyard gardens because we have a schoolyard, or we have a garden in every elementary school in Somerville. We also have a vacant lot that we turned into an abundant food forest on South Street. So we're just looking for people to come out, enjoy the green space, and see some vegetables growing.
This is Juanita Amanda, and we're going to talk to Juanita. How are you having a great time today?
I'm enjoying the sampling and all the things. I just got a massage, and this is great, and we need to have one for the winter, you know, in the fall, to deal with the winter blues, to protect yourself and not to depression and all that. And if you've got to go out, you know how to be careful. So we need to deal that.
We're here with Andrea Libertini from Somerville Cambridge Elder Services, our fabulous friend who's our nutritionist at Somerville Cambridge Elder Services. Andrea, tell me a little bit about what you have here.
Well, we brought a variety of different information, mostly to do with this board is an interactive quiz about how portion sizes have changed over the last 20 years and common products like muffins, bagels, pizzas, sodas, how everything has just been growing with which means more calories, more increased rate of, you know, people struggling to maintain a healthy weight. We also have some information, some activities, some you can kind of see like comparing sodium for different types of soups. Sugar, a lot of information about sugar and trying to keep that low on added sugars, refined sugars. We have like how many sugar packets in a supersized soda, just to give people a visual idea how what it looks like in this form.
Wow.
Which is about 26.
I'm Jadra, and I'm a Simmons student, nutrition student, just helping out for Cambridge Elder Services. And the fast foods are just showing what are the non-healthy options that you have, how many fats are in it, how high the sodium is if you're eating out at the fast food restaurants. This is just showing you better choices, the difference between good and bad choices in terms of fast food restaurants. And this is also just showing all these restaurants are restaurants that people eat at and what they normally would eat and what the amount of calories and fat and sodium are in these meals that you would eat. And this just gives you better choices, the bad choices and the better choices in terms of fast food.
Somerville Council on Aging is now joining the Shape Up Somerville program for healthy eating at restaurants. If you go into a restaurant, ask them if they have a Shape Up Somerville approved menu. And if they do, you'll see a little apple beside the menu, and that tells you it's been approved and it's a healthier way to eat when you go to a restaurant. We're not saying don't go to restaurants. We're saying go out and do healthy choices. So, again, this is a great opportunity. We have a great speaker on right now from Tufts University. We also have a cooking demonstrator coming in, how to cook for one. I mean, so many older adults have been cooking for so many people for so long that it's hard for them to downsize, and this is a great way. So again, sit back, relax, and enjoy the rest of the day.
We had such a great time at the Nutrition Fair, and Betsy, I know you were there along with us, so thank you again for joining us. Again, Betsy, tell everybody, how do they get a hold of our new ADA coordinator in the city?
617-625-6600, extension 2323. If all else fails, just call City Hall and ask for Betsy Allen. And, you know, we were told that we were the best-run city, and having been here for 3 years and now fortunate to be working, I can honestly attest to that. I'm attracted to places that are run well, and this is definitely one of them.
Well, it's leadership by example in the city, and we have a great leader.
Absolutely.
I do also want to say that you are on City Hall hours. The Council on Aging is not. The Council on Aging works Monday through Friday, full days, but you are there Thursday nights.
Correct.
So that's important for the public to know. Even though the Council on Aging isn't there, your office is available, and you're at 167 Holland Street.
Absolutely. Okay. Room number 207, come up and...
Right off the elevator?
Exactly, to the right. And what I would say also, every Tuesday, every second Tuesday of each month, we are going to be running the commission's meetings. The public is welcome to. I want the seniors and everyone to come and express themselves in person, let their feelings be known, and offer their suggestions. We welcome everyone's involvement. We can't do it without the community's engagement and support. And so I'm putting out a call. It's appreciated. It's a welcome. Please tell us what you think and tell us what we're doing and what we can do better.
And tell us, Betsy, where are those meetings going to be held?
In the TAB, in the Tufts Administration, same place, 167 Holland.
And you'll have a sign up that'll direct folks where to go because it's in a back conference room.
Correct.
So we look forward to working with you at the Council on Aging and the city as a whole. I know there's a lot of great things that you'll be doing, and we look forward to all those vast improvements. And once again, thank you and welcome to the city of Somerville.
Thank you very much. I'm thrilled to be here, and I will need your help as I do with the communities.
Thank you. So until next month, we hope you have a great day, and we'll see you real soon.